Hello students, welcome to Triple Department Lecture Videos YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about Electrical Machines Laboratory 1, experiment number 9. The experiment number 9 is voltage regulation of alternator by ZPF method. So, in previous video, we have seen EMF and MMF method. Similarly, here we have to do ZPF method and we will find out the voltage regulation of alternator. Aim: to determine the regulation of an alternator by four tier triangle ZPF method. That is called as a, we will draw the one triangle. So that's what this method we are calling as a four tier triangle ZPF method. So zero power factor method. So ZPF method means here zero power factor. So, since we are using inductive load, the power factor will be 0 here, since the angle between voltage and current is 90 degrees. So, power factor always will measure in terms of cos of angle. So, cos of 90 equal to 0. So, that's what this method is called as a zero power factor method. So, these are the operators are required. Voltmeters, one is AC type, AC type, DC type, ammeter similarly, both AC type and DC type, rheostat, two rheostats we required and connecting wires. So these are the operators are required and mentioned quantity and connecting wires are required to connect the voltmeters to the circuit and ammeters to the circuit. So, current fuse rating. So, fuse rating is 125% of rated current since we are using is load. So, otherwise, so we can take a fuse rating is less than the 125% of rated current. So, whenever we are using the load, so we have to ensure the fuse rating should be 125% of rated current. So, that is 10 amperes. Safety precautions. So, DPST should be open at the time of starting, motor you start in minimum position, generator you start in maximum position. So, these are the procedure for zero power factor method, that is ZPF method. So, connections are made as per the circuit diagram, keep the rheostat of alternator in cut in position and rheostat of motor is cut out position. So, those rheostats should be in cut in and cut out positions. So, switch on power supply by closing the DPST switch, start the motor with the help of a 3-point starter and gradually cut in the field rheostat step by step to bring the motor to the rated speed. Exit the field of alternator by closing the DPST switch with zero reactance load, where is the excitation current and excitation current of the alternator until the generated voltage reaches rated value. Slowly vary the reactance load in steps until the rated armature current and note down the values of excitation. Bring the all rheostats to their original position and switch off the supply. So, this is the experiment procedure. Now, we will see the diagram of the experiment here. The mainly difference between this EMF and MMF method is here we are using inductive load. In EMF method, these terminals are open circuited. MMF method, we have connected rheostats there. We have connected short circuited there. So, in ZPF method, here we are using inductive load. So, inductive load is connected across the alternator. So, this is the motor field rheostat. This is the alternator field rheostat. So, this is a tabular column for the ZPF method. So, here we have to apply rated current by using the inductive load 6.2 amperes and terminal voltage is 185 volts will get. So, regulation using this formula we have to calculate. Okay, this is the circuit diagram. Now, we will move to the demonstration of the experiment.
Now we will demonstrate the ZPF method experiment. So first switch on the DPST switch. Next start the motor by 3-point starter. So now motor is running at some speed. Now motor is running at 1430. So we need to make motor return speed by adjusting it. Field rear start. Now again increase speed of motor. Now motor is running at 1510. So now motor is running at return speed. Now close the DPST switch, adjust the generator field rheostat and the inductive load. Inductive load. Not only line voltage and field current, line current. So line voltage is 120 volts, field current is 0.2, line current is 1 ampere. So adjust the generator field rheostat and inductive load step by step. Note down the line voltage 160 volts, field current 0.28, line current 1.5 ampere. Again adjust the motor field rheostat, generator field rheostat and inductive load, toggle it, hold down the line voltage 180 volts, 0.32, field current is 0.32 and line current is 2 ampere. So similarly adjust the generator field rheostat and inductive load. Note down the line voltage 220. Field current 0.5 ampere and the line current 2.3 ampere. So again adjust the generator field rheostat and inductive load. Now down the line current 230, field current 0.52 ampere. So like that adjust the generator field rheostat and inductive load. So generator gets rated current 6.2 ampere. Now inductive load, after taking the all the readings, inductive load and field rheostat, generator field rheostat to maximum position, open the TPST switch and adjust the motor field rheostat to minimum position, open the DPST switch. So this is about the ZPF experiment. Calculate the voltage regulation and draw the circuit diagram according to readings.
So now we have seen the demonstration of the ZPF method and we will move to the result of this experiment. thus the determination of regulation of alternator by ZPF method. So we using the readings, we can calculate the voltage regulation based on the ZPF method. Okay, thank you everyone.